second word?
I don't know about that. It's probably please or thank you or something like that. But the amen. we did grace in my house before we ate. That apparently was the, you know, so that, you know, my mum and dad would read out a little card, or the kids would read out a card of grace on, and then that was the first word they ever heard me say clearly was the word amen. And here I am today.
It's true, it's a really sweet story.
Anybody from the audience have a question about Charles's first word being amen?
What is mother
back over to Dave. Dave, can you read the second one?
I once entered the Mr. Lester contest.
How old were you?
I was 17. Did you win? I did. There were about 10 men out there for me.
How did you get picked?
Well, it's an entry.
Then you put yourself, yourself out there, as it were, and then we either select it. Certain stages, or you're not selected.
I got through a few stages and then got my
What sort of things did you have to do during the?
Was there a swim?
Well, there was a swim competition, and there was the
three weights lifting
competition. Sorry.
Did you manage to keep swim there?
I did. I made sure it was double tight and like double tight.
So is that when you met Freya?
Any questions from the audience?
On the second occasion, nicked my goalposts. I never got one back. It was a really sad day.
What did the cows do with the goalposts? Did they
play? Well, I don't know how they
managed to get them in Man United.
I don't know how they managed to get the posts out, but I managed to find one with a better bottom. But I did look into the field and see the orange netting just wrapped around kind of a cow's leg.
How much better than your house?
Yeah, no, my first house.
There was a cow at the bottom. They
did, and we complained to the farmer after the first time, and he, you know, put some barbed wire there, but then the second time they still managed to come in.
Wow,
and my next door neighbours had to come in with like sticks and stuff and
the cow!
Yeah, no, they always get the cows out of the garden. And I'm telling you, me and my sisters were terrified when we went outside because there was just this massive kind of cow pat, and we thought there was like a dinosaur or something.
Okay, so audience, do you think this is the truth or a lie? Okay, truth? Or a lie?
It is, in fact, the truth.
Wonderful. Next one up, it's Joe.
Charity
auction event, and my dad went by to work with us. And they had a lot of Harry Potter stuff there. And he won it and brought it back for me. And now it sits in my room next to my bed, and it's signed.
Okay, so this is after the very first film came out?
No, this is after the first part of the seventh film. Oh, okay. So like, I've only had, well, no, it was after that first film before it came out.
So it's next to your bed, right?
Do you have
that
like a candle or something?
It's
kissing
your night. It's off the bedside table because I haven't had a chance to put it on the wall yet. Because my room is normally really messy, so I can get to the wall and put it up.
So do you have it with your kids?
No. I left it at home. It's
why?
Not my
if you left it at home, how much why did you give it at home?
Because I didn't want to worry. Pretty much all my Harry Potter stuff at home because I didn't want to get rid of it.
Or because you were ashamed and embarrassed to have done it.
Okay, so audience, the truth?
Yeah.
Oh, go on, then you say it
down. Oh, it's a silent auction, so what you do is you go
oh,
up.
Oh, so you want, okay.
Oh, that keep it as that time. I believe
it
was about £90. Oh. He loves me lots, and it was for charity. Charity, people!
Okay, so votes for the truth. And votes for a lie.
Ooh, we're divided this time.
I think that's more for a line than the
truth.
Okay. Joe, would you like to reveal if you do indeed have a picture on your by your bedside?
I do. I do. Yes.
Wonderful. Okay, Charles. Right. Number two.
I wanted to name my son Pierce Sean Clapham because I love James Bond, and my wife said no.
Why Pierce first?
Yeah, why Sean second?
Well, surely Sean.
I say, I know a lot of people think that Sean was the best, but I actually genuinely think, and I do love James Bond, I think that Pierce was the best of all the. I know people, you know, I think if you had to label them, you would put Pierce Brosnan. If I had another child now, I might go, I'm going to think Daniel Craig is quite good. But we were making this decision, and we're still in this, so
thought the next child would be Daniel Craig.
Yeah, except that we changed the surname probably, so it would be Daniel Craig Hunt. Oh, okay. And so she would get it. My wife has done the surname, so we would have a sweet, like, popular surname.
So if you're a true like that, what did you think of Diamond and Dave?
I don't know, I quite liked it.
and it's not, I mean, we wouldn't have, I mean, it's not so, I think, Pierre, I mean, when you, it's a funny thing when you go around looking for names, because actually you do look for something that's a little bit out of the box, and you think it's a bit unusual, and you discover that in fact that year everybody's called their game, you know, Grace, we pick Grace out, thinking, this is kind of nice, it's classical unusual, and you discover that actually that was that year's top 10. Life, I mean, Pierce is quite an interesting name. I know nobody ever believes this, but this is definitely not a lie, this bit. You know, and Sean, is the, you know, Sean is the kind of a little bit of a Celtic thing there. I don't know, what's about
that? So any questions from the audience here?
Rachel,
if you like James Bond so much, why didn't you call him James? If you like James Bond so much, why didn't you call him James?
Well, because I like the characters who play James Bond, do you know what I mean? I think, you know, I think I understand that. I think James Bond's quite a cool guy, that's what I think. I'm quite interesting, it's nice.
Okay, so what is it the truth? Or is it a lie?